Hey guys, today we're going to be backing up some Nintendo 64 save files. To do that, we're going to be using this raphnet N64 to USB adapter. This $22 adapter lets us use N64 controllers on our PC, but it also lets us dump memory cards. You can dump Game Boy cards and save files too, but that's a topic for another time. And no, unfortunately you can't use any other cheaper adapter or any USB controllers for this method. Alright, so as you may know, there are two main ways N64 games save data. The first being to a memory card. These are easy to back up, just connect your controller and in a few clicks you've dumped the data, and the backups will even work natively in an emulator. We'll go over this in detail first, it's super fast and easy. The second way games save is directly to the cartridge. These can be a bit harder to dump, but I'll cover these too. My method won't work with all games, but it should work with most. Also, getting these dumps to work in an emulator can be kinda tricky, so I'll have to cover that in a follow-up video. Okay, so let's start off the easy stuff. Memory cards. It's very straightforward. Load your memory card into your controller, and connect your controller to your USB adapter. If you have a two-player adapter like I do, then you'll need to plug it into the player one slot. The second player slot will have a tag on it for easy identification, so make sure you use the other one. Next, connect your adapter to your PC using the included USB cable. Next, you'll need to download the manager software. I'll have it linked in the description. Once the software is open, you'll need to click this little drop-down box and select your adapter. Now you should be able to click Read N64 Memory Pack, and it will load up all the data from your memory card. Once it's loaded, you can save the backup anywhere you'd like. Now when you save the file, you'll see the default name ends in .n64. This is Dex Drive format. It's a fine way to save your backups and it will save some space, but if you want to use your save in an emulator, you'll want to change this to .mpk. MPKs work great for backups and emulators. When you're done naming your file, click Save. And if you just wanted to backup your saves, you're done. Just keep this dump someplace safe. But to get this to work with an emulator, you'll need to know the proper file name. To get this file name, simply boot your ROM using your favorite emulator and run it just long enough to get to the main menu. And now you should see a new file pop up in your emulator's save folder, and it should end in .mpk. Copy the save we dumped to the save folder. And last, we need to rename our dump to match the empty file. A quick and easy way to do this is to right-click and rename the empty file, then copy the text, and delete that empty file. Now rename our dump, and paste in the name we copied earlier, and boot up the emulator, and you should be good to go. Restoring a memory card is also easy. First, go back to the memory card manager. If you've already closed the memory card manager, you can open it again from the tools menu. Now click open, and select what backup you want to restore. Now switch back to the adapter manager, and click write N64 mempack. When it's done, load up your game and all your data should be back. And that's it for memory cards. Now onto the tricky stuff. There's a lot to explain before we can get started, so if you're new to cart dumping, this may all sound a little complex, but just follow along. After your first backup, it actually becomes super easy. It's really just a few short steps. Alright, cartridge types. It's important to know what type of cartridge you're working with. If you're not sure, you can look up your game in the link below. There are three main save types. First is SRAM. Used in games like Ocarina of Time, Harvest Moon, and F-Zero, just like with Game Boy games, your save files are stored on a chip that needs constant power. If your battery dies, so does your save file. They can be backed up and restored from your computer, but sadly, getting these to work in an emulator can require quite a bit of work and technical skill, so I won't be covering how to convert these anytime soon. The second and much more popular type is EEPROM. These don't hold as much data as SRAM, but they use reprogrammable memory that doesn't need a battery. Most cartridges use this format, and we can back them up just like SRAM, and with a little work, we can get these to work in an emulator. The third type uses flash memory. This holds much more data than even SRAM, but it doesn't use a battery. This format is also fairly uncommon, and is mainly used for games like Pokemon Stadium and StarCraft 64. Sadly, my backup method won't work for these at all, but if you check the link and find your game uses SRAM or EEPROM, you should be good to go. Okay, in order to back up your cart save, you're going to need a GameShark or Action Replay, along with a memory card. If you don't already have a GameShark, I suggest picking up a version 3.2 or 3.3. And here's where the annoying stuff begins. If your GameShark refuses to boot, and you've tried cleaning it in the cartridges, your GameShark may have the wrong key code. The default key code works fine for stuff like Super Mario 64, GoldenEye, and most games, but some games like Banjo, Zelda, and F-Zero require changing the key code. To do this, you have to boot from a different game first, for example, GoldenEye, then scroll down to key codes. And here you have a few options to pick from. Check the link in the description for a list of popular games and what key codes they use. Select the code you want and press A to change codes. Make sure you only switch the games you actually have, because you'll need a compatible game to change it back. You can actually lock yourself out of the GameShark. There's no way to manually reset the code. Once you're able to boot the GameShark with the game you want to dump, just go to Memory Card Manager and load up your game pack on the left. If you don't see a game pack option, you can try cleaning the game and restarting, but it likely means your game can't be dumped. If you can load it up, you should see a save name. Now go to the right side and select Controller 1. If it says your memory card needs to be formatted, press L and format it. Once you can open the memory card, delete any files you see. This just makes things easier in the long run. Next, go back to the left side window and press A to transfer your cartridge save file to your memory card. This will take a little while, but once it's done, your save should be transferred. You can now transfer this to your PC, just like we did with the memory card saves. Just click Read N64 Mempack. The memory card will appear empty, however you will see that some pages are used up. That means we got the dump, but this software just can't read it. That's fine. Save this anywhere you want, and it's a good idea to do a quick check on your save. I have yet to get any corrupted saves from the GameShark, but I have gotten one or two blank ones. SRAM's a bit hard to check because the GameShark formats them weirdly. I don't really understand how they work yet, but I'd at least suggest checking the size. The GameShark shows the Ocarina save file should be 11 blocks. So a backup that's 11 blocks is pretty normal, but if you happen to get something crazy like this 83 block save, then you know something's wrong. Try backing up the save again. You can also check the size of your dumps in the Mempack editor. EEPROM are a bit more straightforward. One quick way to test is to see how much data is in your dump. Extract it using this website, linked below, click the little download button, and now we have our extracted dump. You can do a quick check by opening this in Notepad. If you see a mostly empty page with just a few symbols on the first 1 to 2 lines, it's likely it's a bad save. A good save should have much more junk, like this. Notepad can't actually read the save data, but it knows there's much more of it there. For more advanced users, you can open it in the hex editor. This is completely optional, but it'll give you a better idea of how much data there is. This is really just a sanity check to help prevent empty saves. If your save's really important, you may want to do some further testing. Okay, next we'll be restoring some cartridge saves from our PC. First, open up Mempack Editor, then load a backup. Next, switch to the Adapter Manager and click Write N64 Mempack. Then connect your controller to your N64 and boot up GameShark's Memory Card Manager. This time, we'll have the controller on the left and the game pack on the right. On the left side window, press A to copy the save file, and it will be transferred back to your cartridge. Boot up the game, and you should see your save file. Alright, and I think that's all we have time for today. Stay tuned for the next video where I cover converting EEPROM saves for emulators. It should be out by Monday, but it does get kind of crazy. We have to break out the hex editor again. Special thanks to everyone who helped compile the information for this video. I'll try to link all my sources below. This video would not have been possible without them. But anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.